I'm Anthony L. Elmore, president and founder of the Proud Black Buddhist World Association, here to bring you another exciting Black Buddhist lecture. It is important that you have Black Buddhist teachers. Our lecture for today, Become a Black Buddhist Voice. This is what you must understand about the Buddhist teachings. Asians, white people, and blacks have been taught Buddhism by Asians and white people. Strip away the Buddhist teachings, the black culture, the history, and the language has all been extricated from Buddhism. If you are black and Buddhist, you do not have your black culture, history, and language. You do not have Buddhism, but what you getting from Asians and white people, you are getting Asian culture when you strip away your history, your language, and your culture. Please understand that in our entire world, there does not exist one single black man in the world who is known and respected in the black community as a Buddhist. See, the reason that you do not have great black Buddhist teachers is because Asians and white people strip the black voice out of Buddhism. You see, we practice the teachings of Buddhism as taught by the 13th century black Japanese sage Nichiren Shonin. Now, Nichiren taught Buddhism by ways of letters. These letters are kind of like a Bible. They're called the Gosho. And there is a Gosho titled The Sacred Teachings of the Buddha's Lifetimes. And this Gosho reads, quote, "In regards to the word Kyo, profound meaning says, the voice carries out the work of the Buddha. This is called Kyo or Sutra." You see, in the 21st century, ladies and gentlemen, Sutra or the voice is the teaching. The way that we teach and the way we learn is through the voice. See, let me talk black. No white man and certainly no Asian man understands the power and influence of the voice in the black community more than black people understand the power of the voice. You see, the reason that black people in America were strong enough to survive slavery was that the black voice. See, when black people were struggling and going through the hard times, it was that voice. They would sing and they would reach down and the voice would give some inspiration. It is a voice that carries the spirit. You see, it was the voice of Frederick Douglass, Booker T. Washington, Dr. Martin Luther King, Malcolm X, Mahalia Jackson, Aretha Franklin, Whitney Houston. It was the black voice that created all of the forms of the popular music in America. See, this is what the Gosho title, Pure and Far-Reaching Voice, reads. Now, this Gosho reads, quote, "Lotus Sutra is a manifestation in writing of the Thus Come One Shakyamuni's intent. It is his voice set down in written words. Thus, the Buddha's heart is emboldened in these written words. To illustrate, it's like seeds that sprout, grow into plants, and produce rice. Though the form of the rice changes, the essence remains the same." You see, rice changes, but it's the same. Just as the Lotus Sutra is the heart and soul of the Buddha, even though it's in its written form, it is the soul of the Buddha. It is the spirit of the Buddha. Now, let's take this thing just a little further. You see, the words of the Lotus Sutra is the voice of the Buddha in a different form. Now, the Gosho further reads, it says, Shakyamuni Buddha and the written words of the Lotus Sutra are two different things, but their heart is one. Therefore, when you cast your eyes upon the words of the Lotus Sutra, you should consider that you are beholding the living body of the Dust Come One, Shakyamuni, unquote. You see, when you chant the Lotus Sutra, you are tapping the spirit of the Buddha. You see, please understand that quiet meditation is only one aspect of Buddhism. You see, the Gosho is called the Doctrine of the 3,000 Realms reads, quote, "But if there are those who will listen to this sutra, then they are capable of practicing the Bodhisattva way in a fitting manner." And it goes on further. It said, if the sutra meant that one could attain Buddhahood through contemplation of the mind alone, then why would it speak of seeing, hearing, reading, reciting? See, the sutra makes hearing the sole basis of practice, unquote. You see, let me repeat. The sacred teachings of the Buddha's lifetime again reads, in regards to the word kyo, profound meaning says, the voice carries out the work of the Buddha. This is called kyo or sutra. Let me put this in a way that you can understand. I want to take you back to January the 8th, 2016. Now, this is at the birth of my son, Siddhartha Gautama Elmore. Now, we are in the delivery room and my wife is having a C-section and my baby is born. Now, this baby, as he comes out, he lets you know he is in the world. The baby has a voice. That voice lets you know he's here. Let's
suction in his mouth. Okay. You okay?
Yeah.
Okay. He's doing great. Now we're gonna bring the shoulders out. Okay.
Okay.
All right. Are you breathing?
Yeah.
You just look like you just tipped.
Oh,
he's handsome. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Congratulations. Thank you. Ooh, listen to him. There you go.
Oh, my God.
Welcome to motherhood. Wow.
Let me tell you another story about divorce. You see, in 1968, when Dr. Martin Luther King was killed, we black people were very sad and we did not know what to do. It was a sutra, or it was the voice of James Brown who wrote a sutra. Now, the sutra was called Say It Loud. I'm black and proud. You see, we chanted this Say It Loud and I'm black and I'm proud. And the black people woke up. We stopped being colored and Negro, but we became black through a sutra. Now,
James Brown's I'm Black and I'm Proud was an affirmation of self-respect. And it was a challenge to others to respect themselves and to respect him.
Brother, we can't quit until we get our shit.
Everybody was trying to think of what to say about Martin Luther King getting shot, about the situation in America, the civil rights movement. Everybody just wanted to know how to capsulize it. And so when James Brown said, say it loud, I'm black and I'm proud, that said it. That's it. So when he said it, everybody hollered back, I'm black and I'm proud.
The words were magical. I mean, that was the ultimate emancipation.
In regards to religion, black people are not going to listen to an Asian. Become a black Buddhist voice and bring Buddhism to our black community. I am Anthony F. Elmore, president and founder of the Proud Black Buddhist World Association, bringing you another Black Buddhist lecture. Become a Black Buddhist voice.